folks, I ended up going down to Pennsylvania Plow Day this year, and I really enjoyed it. I had a good weekend, a lot of fun, met a lot of new people down there, and really enjoyed the event. So I know a couple of you are asking, from what I heard, as to whether I drove my 77 GMC down there, because I said I was going to road trip it. Unfortunately, I did not in some cases. Hugh and James had got a hold of me about a month before the trip, and they said they're going to have some extra room on the trailer for the ride down for the four-wheel drive, so I figured either a $250 gas bill, or I can kick some to them for fuel, and I could save quite a bit on the trip. So I ended up doing that, and it wasn't a complete loss because we kind of had crappy weather down there for the weekend. It ended up raining most of the day on Friday for the trip down. It was pretty crappy. It was a lot of mud down there. And Saturday was all right. It was nice and sunny, but it was sort of chilly out. And then the ride home on Sunday was really crappy and rainy. So it wouldn't have exactly been a nice road trip for the 77. So it wasn't a huge loss. And the four-wheel drive did pretty good for about a row and a half. And then unfortunately, I ended up seizing the drive planetaries in the rear transmission. I didn't have enough oil in the back because I figured without the engine, you don't need as much oil. Apparently, I was pretty wrong on that aspect. And it seized them cold dead. I stopped right in the middle of the field real fast when they locked up. Because with the hill, I never worried much about it because as I'm going down, they end up getting bathed in oil, and then when I go back up again, they'll be okay. But it's all flat land out there, and it's not going to get splashed around like it does here on the hill. So not having enough in the transmission, they heated up and they seized pretty darn tight. So I had to disengage the four-wheel drive and drive out with the front transmission. Luckily, I was able to get out of the field with it. So I didn't get to plow all day with it like I was hoping, but for the short time that I did, it ran great. The three-point hitch that I built, that worked out really nice. Luckily enough, Cunningham's Cadets on YouTube was nice enough to loan me a 10-inch Brindley plow for it, and that worked out really slick on the back. So now I'm going to be on the hunt for a 10-inch plow for the back, so that way if I manage to go next year, I'll be able to plow with this and have more oil in the rear transmission too. So I have enough planetaries to fix that, but it's going to be sitting here for a little while because I don't want to work on it for a couple of weeks. So maybe towards the end of this month I'll pull it out again and get the rear transmission squared away on it, and I'll be back up and running again. So since I wasn't able to use that for most of the day, James has a diesel Sears that I had jumped on for a while, and then I met another guy down there who had a Sears SS16 that I ended up plowing with for a bit too. So towards the end of the video, or halfway through, you'll see some clips of both of those tractors. But aside from the four-wheel drive having that issue, it was a really great weekend, and hopefully I'll get back down there next year, providing that work and life and everything else pans out and coincides and whatnot. So anyways, folks, here's a bunch of clips from Plow Day, and I hope you all enjoy them. Well, folks, we're here down at Hughes in Connecticut. Gonna be taking off for Plow Day. Get everything loaded up. Tell you what, folks. Folks, we're here at Plow Day, Saturday. Rain finally stopped and things are drying out, so everyone's getting all weighted up and ready this morning, and we can start plowing.
Hopefully we don't have to lose battery, we might have to do this again. Thank you.
Thank you.
on now.
How far back do I have to get?
Oh, yeah.